Hi, this is Pete, call sign K7PP, with the continuing saga of the boat anchors. We're going to be discussing today actual use. How do you put them on the air? I mean, we talked about tuning them up, but these are a little bit different than modern day transceivers. These are not your average point and click devices. They actually require a little bit of skill in getting things together and netted up, as we say, or zero beaded. We have a Hammerland receiver on one side and a Johnson Viking Valiant AM amplitude modulation, or ancient modulation as sometimes they're referred to, transmitter. And these units are 1959 vintage, both of them. You'll notice that they both have separate dials. The receiver allows you to tune in a particular station, and the transmitter dial allows you to dial up the frequency of that station so that you can transmit back to them. But getting them together, how do we do that? Well, we've already discussed how to tune up the Valiant, so we won't dwell too much on that, but the actual receiver, the receiver is another story. Now we receive an AM signal, we're going to listen to just a plain ordinary carrier. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to turn on my calibrator so that I simulate a carrier. And we turn the volume up, and all I hear is a little bit of static. As I tune through the signal, you can see the meter peak showing the maximum indication of signal strength. And I've got an electric fence outside, that's why the popping. But nonetheless, there's our signal. Somebody could be talking. If I move up the band a little bit, I'll actually hear people talking on AM.
You know, even the experts don't have a clue.
Well, thank you. Anyway, there is our simulated carrier. Somebody could be talking. Now the idea is to zero beat them with the transmitter. There is a function on the transmitter called zero, which I've turned on. And now I'm going to listen for a zero beat as I tune the dial. I'm going to tune the VFO, or the variable frequency oscillator, the device that actually generates the radio signal. And I should be able to hear it against the calibrator and the other radio if I listen carefully. And now I've zero-beated the signal. I'm off frequency, on frequency, off frequency, on frequency. The idea is to get this radio signal the same as the frequency of this radio signal. So now I'm going to try and zero-beat or simulate the I'm not going to simulate now. I'm actually going to tune in a station. And we will take the transmitter. And we'll zero beat this signal.
It is a democracy after all. And, you know, when you get to the point where we are, where there's pretty. Get to a point, you know, where you can't reverse that. Entitlements are irreversible. Just ask your favorite Greek or European. You know,
there's our signal.
Irish, Spanish. They can tell you about how irreversible that is. You can't take it back.
All right, now my signal, my transmitter is zero beated on that particular station. And what do we mean by zero beating? Well, if you have a radio signal with nothing on it at all, there's really nothing to hear. If you have two of those radio signals and they're on exactly dead on the same frequency, you still don't have anything to hear. But if one of the signals is just a little bit different than the other, you get the sum of the two, the difference of the two, of course, the two originals. Some difference in the two originals, plus many harmonics. And what that means is it'd be the same as if you had two pianos and you hit a C and a D. You would hear the sum of the two, the difference of the two, and the two originals. So that's why we actually hear a tone, is because we're listening to the difference between the two radio signals. The one that's actually on the air transmitting, the other one coming out of the AM transmitter, and the two coming together in a zero beat, which means they're both on the same identical frequency. Make sense? Well, once that happens, when I get ready to transmit, all I have to do is key the transmit paddle, and the transmitter will come on and transmit on the same frequency. There are other ways to go about this. You can initiate a call using crystals. The transmitter is also equipped with several fixed crystal frequencies. If you have a favorite frequency that you like to frequent, then all you have to do is dial up the crystal and you're automatically there. There's no tuning the main dial at all. You're just on whatever is printed on the frequency or crystal frequency, that's where you are. So there you have it, a kind of a short tutorial as to how to actually put this monstrosity on the frequency you want to transmit. Keep your eyes open for these old girls. They're on eBay and Craigslist and many other types of lists, and pick one up, clean it up, and put her on the air and join the fun on AM. This is K7PP, Pete, looking for you on the radio. Bye-bye.